Welcome to biology exams for you. In this video we are going to discuss some previous questions of ecology. So now you have approximately 20 days for the exam. Work out maximum number of questions, gain confidence, and that is it all that matters. So if you ask me to pick out a topic which is of the most importance in CSIR, which is Unit Life Sciences, I think from my experience I could tell that ecology, you can expect at least 5 to 10 questions consistently from this part. Now let us work out some questions together. This was a question that appeared in June 2006. The type of vegetation in climate having temperature range 5 to 20 degrees Celsius and rainfall 150 to 300 centimeter will be. Options are temperate deciduous, temperate evergreen, taiga, and grasslands. And this is a question you can answer if you thoroughly know the matter. But here also you can apply some logic. From the temperature range, that is 5 to 20 degrees Celsius, you know that it may not be taiga, as taiga the conditions are extreme. Grasslands, the temperature will be above 20 degrees Celsius. So now you have two options to pick out, temperate evergreen and temperate deciduous. So this temperature range is a mid-range, and also the rainfall range is a mid-range. So the answer will be temperate deciduous. Now let us look into the answer. Temperate deciduous, and you have the explanation. So these questions, this type of questions, if you want to answer, my suggestion is you don't rush into the answer. You should be at least 80% sure before reaching a conclusion of picking out an option, as negative marks are often an obstacle between you and your dream. Now moving into the second question. Among the following, which is the best indicator of water pollution due to mixing of human feces? Options are Paramecium, Bacillus, Trichinosoma, and E. coli. And this is a direct question, and you can expect very little questions like this. And options, you know, E. coli is an intestinal bacteria. We often check for contamination by determining the presence of E. coli in water or not. So answer is E. coli. Now the third question. Among the following, which is not a characteristic feature of our selected species? Options are maturity at later stage, option B, large clutch size, option C, small size of offspring, and option D, maturity at early stage of life. And this is a question, this is a topic that is R selected and K selection, and continuously, consistently, you can expect some question from this topic. And my suggestion is you should learn this topic. That is very simple. R selected, R stands for rapid, just remember bacterium. It is having rapid growth, rapid reproduction rate, more number of offsprings, short lifespan, and these are the characters of R selected species. And for K-selected species, we just remember ourselves. Humans comes under K-selected species. So, long lifespan, less number of offsprings, less allocation of energy for reproduction, and these are large adult size. These are some characteristics of K-selected species. So now let us look into the options. Maturity. So the question is, among the following, which is not a characteristic of our selected species? Large clutch size, that is large number of offsprings, that is a characteristic of our selected species. Small size of offspring, it is a characteristic of our selected species. Just take the example of bacteria or an insect. Then maturity at an early stage of life, that is also a characteristic of our selected species. The only options we have is option A, and that will be the answer. Maturity at later stage. Now moving into the next question, it has been observed that bacteria secretes toxin at high population density to check the population size. The phenomenon is termed as quorum sensing, option A, option B, population control, option C, allelopathy, and option D, interspecific competition. Here, allelopathy you might be knowing. Many organisms or many plants, even bacteria, secretes certain chemicals in order to prevent the growth of other species around them. Plants are using many chemicals to create clear zones around the roots, so that there will be less competition for nutrients. Here the answer is quorum sensing, where a bacteria has a property of secreting certain toxins that will check the population number so that the competition will be less. And now moving into the next question, the accumulation of DDT has decreased the population of pelican ducks because DDT, option A, killed all duckin, option B, decreased availability of calcium for eggshells, which leads to thin shelled fragile eggs, option C, stopped synthesis of eggs, option D, interfered calcium metabolism. And this, you might be knowing that the video of this particular thing, effect, has been shown in National Geographic Channel often. And the reason is there was a reduction in population size of these pelican ducks, drastic reduction. So a research was carried out in order to find out the reason, and found out that DDT was the culprit at that time. Actually, this DDT interferes with calcium metabolism, and option B is the answer, where decreased availability of calcium for eggshells, which leads to thin shelled eggs, so that it may not mature, it will not mature. Here option D is also in interfering with calcium metabolism, but the more correct option is, the best choice is option B. Now the next question, hotspots are primarily designated on basis of hotspots. You know that hotspots are region of high endemism. Endemism, that means many species that are present in hotspots may not be present anywhere in the world, or species that are localized in a restricted area, that is called as endemism. Now, the next question, phytoplankton spends very little energy on developing protective structures against predator. This suggests that why? Option A, food chain is small. Option B, there is less competition. Option C, productivity of aquatic ecosystem is slow. Option D, assimilation efficiency is high in aquatic ecosystem. So in oceans, the most productive areas are where phytoplankton resides. And phytoplankton, as you all know, these are small algae, which are photosynthetic and which doesn't have much undigestible part. And their growth is abundant. And obvious reason is there is less competition. Then question number 8, temporary fluctuation in population size is due to migration, option A, option B, carrying capacity, option C, bottleneck phenomenon, and option D, interspecific competition. Here the answer is bottleneck phenomenon. Normally, at times there will be a drastic reduction in population number, maybe due to some environmental catastrophe, and that is referred to as bottleneck, drastic reduction in number of population size. Then soon the population recover from these and attain a normal level. And this area is also very important, that is bottleneck phenomenon, founder effect, migration, genetic drift, etc. Then, question number 9, stenohaline organisms can, it is a term, so you should note the term in order to answer this question. Option A, tolerate narrow range of salt concentration. Option B, tolerate wide range of salt concentration. Option C, escapes salty conditions. Option D, can secrete extra salt to keep salt amount constant. And the answer is stenohaline organisms can tolerate narrow range of salt concentration. And the other one that is capable of tolerating wide range of salt concentration is called as urehaline. So while working out CSIR questions or MCQ questions, my suggestion is you have to go through the four options. The second option may be the option that is not answer for this question will be the question next time. So you should have a knowledge about all the four options. Question number 10. Effective population size for completely monogamous species having 40 males and 10 females would be. And this is a question, not to answer this question, you should, there is an equation. Let us look into the equation. Effective population size NE is equal to 4NM and into NF by NM plus NF, where NM is the number of breeding males and NF is the number of breeding females. The equation is very simple and the answer will be 4 into 40 into 10 by 40 plus 10, that is 1650, that is 32. So to answer this question, you should know the formula, and that is it. So for more detailed explanation of these questions and answers and many other resources for your preparation, visit www.biologyexamsforyou.com. Thanks for watching.